Today I want to go over the whole Vic Mignogna situation and the lawyer who's been covering him, Nick Ricada. First of all, Vic Mignogna. This guy, I first ran into him in 2007 at TechnicCon, a convention in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. He is a voice actor. I did not know much about him, but I had seen the Full Metal Alchemist dub. He plays the voice of Edward Elric, the main character of the series. So I thought, okay, cool, let me check out one of his panels, see what it's all about. So he's there at his panel, and I go in, sit down, and I can see quite clearly why he's so popular, especially with teenage girls, because he's a handsome guy, has a nice voice, he's a good storyteller, very charismatic, he's very open with his fans. He was telling some stories about, voice acting, telling some stories about his police officer days. He was telling a little bit about, previous conventions, how he got drunk at one of them, was acting like a bit of a jerk, so he decided to, put his best foot forward and, try to act a little bit better going forward. So seemed like a very genuine guy, someone more than capable of making mistakes, but also someone who would own up to them if he did, and seemed pretty cool. I wouldn't go out of my way to see one of his panels after that, but if I had free time, sure, why not? And I don't watch a lot of dub shows anymore, so I wouldn't go out of my way to watch something with a particular dub voice actor, even if I thought he was doing a good job. But I would be happy to watch something dubbed by him, no big deal. So that was that. Next time I saw him was in 2009 at Anime Week in Atlanta. And this time he said that he had some sort of video to show that he made about him cosplaying as, and some of the other voice actors I think also cosplaying as Full Metal Alchemist characters and suddenly showing up in your neighborhood. So he said that he could not display this video online because he said that the studio viewed the video, thought it looked a little too professional, and didn't want anyone to get the wrong idea about it, so he could display it at conventions, but not display it online. That was enough to get me into the room to watch the video, and it was pretty cool, whatever. And this time I also find out about his Reasonable Rangel fan club, mostly teenage girls, I believe, who are really big fans of his, and really supporting him in the role. And also, it was kind of cool to see that Full Metal Alchemist, by this point, who's already been a few years old, but and yeah, the new series Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood was coming out probably around this time, but to see him still so dedicated to that role he was doing a few years earlier, it's cool. He was really into his work, he was really enjoying the fans, it seemed like, and everything was cool. Since then, online, through Twitter and various things, I had heard random accusations that he had been sexually assaulting people, and I didn't know what to think about it. On one hand, I want to take accusations seriously. On the other hand, it's just internet rumors. Whoever's really involved in this case, of course, should go to the police or should have this investigated. I'm not involved in this. I'm as distant as I could possibly be from the situation. So whoever is actually in the situation, they're the ones who should be taking action, whatever. I'm not the one who should be passing judgment knowing nothing about it. And then the most recent issues come around where the Broly movie from Dragon Ball Z, where he's playing Broly, it comes out back in January, and at this time he's accused by a lot of people of sexual misconduct, and so he's basically booted out of the anime voice acting industry at this time. And here is where Nick Ricada steps in. So Nick Ricada, well, like me, also a lawyer, he was a fan of Maddox and Dick Masterson's podcast, The Biggest Problem in the Universe, back when it was first coming out in 2015 or so. And then Maddox and Dick Masterson split up. They started their own podcast. Maddox sues Dick Masterson with a terribly written lawsuit. And so what Nick Ricada does is he makes a video series where he gets drunk, he goes through some of these documents from the lawsuit, and he rips them to shreds. He rips them to shreds, as he should, because these documents are absolute garbage. And he does a really good job at them. He's, charismatic in his own right. He takes his legal analysis, and he does a good job explaining why these lawsuits are so just poorly written and why these documents are absolute garbage. And he develops a bit of a fandom from fans of The Dick Show. So he slowly grows his channel by covering other lawsuits as well. He covered some of these, lawsuits against Google for sex discrimination against men and Asians. He covered some comics book, Comics Gate lawsuits and Comics Gate legal issues. He's covered quite a few things. He covered some of the Kavanaugh hearings, and this time he kind of expressed his opinion that even though, whether Kavanaugh committed sexual assault against, attempted rape against the woman who accused him notoriously, whether that actually happened or not, there's no proof, no action was filed at that time, and even if something like that happened, you can't hold it against him at a future time. That was his set of beliefs. Also, Nick, he was he's a conservative Christian guy, so he shares that point of view that he feels like it's many people are being unfairly accused from the conservative and Christian side. Nick is a defense attorney, so he tends to take the view quite naturally that of defending the accused. You know, I was a prosecutor at one point, so I kind of grew into the opposite view that I'm more likely to believe the accuser than the accused. But at the same time, I think that all cases should be properly, thoroughly, and impartially investigated. So he finds out about the Vic situation when Vic is being accused by a bunch of people. He looks into it and decides that he comes out very squarely on the side of Vic, who's also like this conservative Christian guy, and who he believes is completely innocent in the situation. And at the very least, even if he were to be guilty, the issue should at least be tried with facts and evidence. There should be some sort of process for hearing the whole situation out instead of just a few accusations just coming out rapid fire on Twitter and that being the end of this guy's career. And I empathize with certain points of that. I think that, yes, cases should be tried out. Even if not officially in court, people should completely be heard out before action is taken. In this case, it seemed like just based on accusations that were really planned to have a snowball effect right as this movie was coming out, to completely get this guy out of the industry, I don't think that's the right way of doing this. Now, I was on the sidelines for a long time because I wanted all this evidence to come out before deciding whose side to take. I wanted all these evidence, investigations to be carried out. I wanted all the evidence to be analyzed. And now official documents have been filed. There is actually a lawsuit now, and from the evidence I have seen right now, I have to come out right now on the side of Vic Mignogna, because the evidence coming out against him is really sketchy, and I think that at the very least, the accusations against him have been exaggerated if they are not downright false and defamatory. So I'm going to probably cover more of this situation as the evidence comes in, as the documents drop, and go over it in more detail. But right now, yes, I do want to announce that I am on the side of Vic in this thing. I think that based on what I've seen so far, it is completely improper to accuse him of what he's been accused of, and especially, even if some of it has some sort of truth at its core and it has just been exaggerated or blown out of proportion, that is simply not enough to completely throw this guy out of the industry, to make the kind of comments that would probably keep him from finding employment in the future. That's absolutely inappropriate. So basically, to cover what I've seen so far, there are two causes of action that are at the heart of this. One is defamation, and the other is tortious interference with business prospects. One of them is just like people just maliciously making statements about him to cause him harm that are untrue. That's defamation. And the other one, tortious interference with business prospects, that's making these kinds of comments with the intention and the fact of keeping him from finding future employment. I think these are both legitimate cases. I don't know if he'll actually prevail on them, but there is certainly evidence out there that I've seen that makes me at least think these are definitely not frivolous suits. There is definitely a real case to be had here. So I'm going to cover this more in the future. I just want to say that Nick is doing a great job here. I'm really surprised that he was able to raise the amount he did, especially since until like January when this case first came out, Nick didn't know a thing about Vic. But he was able to set this goal of $150,000. Well, it was initially $100,000. Now it's over $150,000. But not knowing a guy at all, setting that goal and being able to rally support behind it, that's really incredible. So hats off to you, Nick. Great job. You know, I've been following this guy's YouTube channel for over a year now. I've been listening to almost every single one of his videos. I don't always agree with him on his analysis, but his analysis is quite sound. He is a good legal mind, and yes, he is a real lawyer. So I look forward to seeing more of his analysis as the case goes forward. And I hope that justice is served regardless of what the outcome is, but right now I do have to take the side of Vic. I think that what's going on around him is at least procedurally completely unfair, and now it's looking more like substantively as well, it is completely unfair. So more about this later, but for now, I'm looking forward to seeing how this gets resolved, or at least how it proceeds.